I know, it can be confusing. You're told you have to fertilize your garden, but you don't know when you're supposed to fertilize or how much you're supposed to fertilize. Then I come along and I pose the question at you, do you even need to fertilize? Hi, I'm Gardener Scott, a master gardener who discusses everything gardening so that you can become a better gardener. Today, let's talk about fertilizer. All of my training and all of my experience lead to a pretty simple answer when it comes to the question of whether you need to fertilize or not. And I'll give you that secret here in just a little bit. For now, let's talk about the plants. Plants need nutrients. And that's why you're told to fertilize, because fertilizers contain the primary nutrients that plants need. So, go buy fertilizer, put it on your plants will grow, you'll have a great harvest. But I'm here today to tell you there's something else you should be focusing on. And it's not just the plants. I'll use my own garden as an example. So this is kind of a pop quiz, and you get to decide what you think the results are, or maybe should be. So I have fertilized some areas of my garden, and I have not fertilized other areas of my garden. So let's start right here with these carrots, with the beets, with the pumpkins. Look at these plants. I'll give you a second. Which of these do you think I've fertilized? And now look at these plants, this squash and cucumbers. Take a good close look. Which of these plants did I fertilize this year? And there's a whole bunch of plants here, so look all around. I've got cucumber, I've got carrots, I've got spinach, I have beets, I have turnips, I have kale, and I've got chard. In this bed, I've got chard, I've got cucumbers, I have some beets, and then I've got some turnips that are going to seed. Lots of plants in these two different beds. Take a look closely. Which of these plants did I fertilize this year? So I've given you a lot of plants to look at in different beds in my garden, and I know they all look green, they all look lush, they've all been very productive, and I've been harvesting for quite a while. Were you taking notes? Which plants looked like they were doing better? And if you want to stop right now and go back before I give you the answer, you can take another look at these plants to try to figure out which ones were fertilized. Are you ready for the answer? None of them. None of these plants that I showed you did I fertilize this year. Yes, I know. It might blow your mind a bit. That's why I asked the question, do you even need fertilizer? Because I have a beautiful growing garden and I haven't fertilized any of these plants. It's because of the secret, the key, the answer to why I don't have any of these plants needing fertilizer. Okay, I know you're dying for the answer. What's the secret, Gardener Scott? Why don't you fertilize your plants? Well, here it comes. It's all about the soil. The plants need nutrients, and we can douse the plants with all the fertilizer we want, but we need to look at it this way. If you feed your soil, the soil will feed your plants. You don't have to rely on feeding your plants if you take that perspective. And that's my whole philosophy to gardening. The soil. The soil is key. And I've said this in many other videos, but you can actually see it in action now that I have plants growing in my garden. I put organic material in my soil, a lot of organic material. I encourage the soil organisms. I mulch with organic materials as well. And when you do all of that, well, you can have a rich soil. And you may not need to use fertilizer at all. Now, I will acknowledge that there are times that you should consider adding fertilizer. You can't get rich soil overnight. And I'll use this bed as an example. This was the very first bed that I built last year. and therefore the very first bed that I filled with soil. And I used a lot of organic material, buried some logs and branches at the bottom, but I didn't add any fertilizer. And then I planted garlic in this bed. And the garlic was in place for about 9 months before I harvested it last month. Well, the soil during that time was showing increased signs of life. A huge amount of earthworms found this bed. I didn't put earthworms in, they found it because of all the organic material. Well, when I harvested the garlic, I realized the soil was becoming quite dense, and a lot of that organic material had decomposed and was food for the earthworms. So I added a lot more organic material, and because I wanted to plant right away all of these beautiful fall crop leafy greens, I needed to ensure that these plants would have enough nutrients. So as I was amending this soil with all that organic matter, I did add some inorganic fertilizer to the soil, not to the plants. So the soil has organics, it has some fertilizer, and the plants, as you can see, are doing great. And here's an important point about fertilizer in your garden, as we fertilize the soil and not the plant. It takes time for all of that organic material to break down. When we use compost and other organic matter and we amend our soil with it, it takes a while for the earthworms and the other soil organisms to find it. It takes a while for the bacteria to decompose it. When it does decompose, it releases nutrients into the soil. And that's what our plants need, is those nutrients. But because it takes time, if we're starting a bed or putting plants in shortly after we amend the soil, well then there's an ample consideration for the need of fertilizer. I did it in this bed too. I actually didn't create this bed until most of the other garden was planted. So I used native soil, again, a lot of organic material, but I knew it wouldn't break down this season. So I added some more inorganic fertilizer. Osmocote is what I used in this bed. And then I've got the green beans, I've got squash, I've got these beautiful tomatoes all growing in this bed with organic material that is continuing to decompose, but there's also some nutrients that are already in place from the fertilizer that I added. So there was a single application of fertilizer to the soil on some of my beds, the ones that I filled this year and wanted to use right away. Those beds that I showed you at the beginning that had no fertilizer at all, well, I filled those beds last year and then amended in the fall, or filled this year early and amended in early spring. That gave enough time for all of those wonderful soil microorganisms to get to work and start releasing nutrients. And you can see just how well all these plants are doing. But all of these wonderful plants are also sucking up a lot of those nutrients. So I have to do it all over again this year. This fall, I'm adding more organic material to the soil. If the soil looks like it's depleted, I might add some of that inorganic fertilizer, and I'll just play it as it comes. I'm trying not to add fertilizer if I don't need to. I'm trying to rely on the organic material as much as possible. And how long do I need to do this for? Well, in as early as 3 years, if you amend your soil regularly with a lot of organic material, you'll reach an equilibrium point. It might take as long as 5 years, but 3 to 5 years of this regular amending will build your soil to the point that it is packed with all of the nutrients that the plants need. And that's why no-dig gardening works so well, is once the soil reaches that equilibrium and is filled with nutrients, all you have to do is just add more compost and more mulch to the top of the soil, and it all becomes incorporated by those organisms. Before that 3 to 5 year period, it's okay. You can use fertilizer like I do, but a single application into the soil in those first 3 years is probably all that's needed in the fall or maybe in the spring. And this isn't an earth-shattering garden discovery. This is the way nature does it. Think about every forest in the world, filled with trees and plants and animals and healthy ecosystems. And there's nobody driving through there with a truck fertilizing the forest floor. It takes care of itself. It's that equilibrium point where more organic material falls on the soil and it continues to enrich the soil for as long as that forest remains in place. One of the reasons we think we need fertilizer is because of what we've done to ourselves in the last couple hundred years, where we started expansive corporate farming. We tore down some of these forests and we just planted the same plant for mile and mile and mile as you drive down a road. And so what happens when you monocrop like that? Well, you're taking all the nutrients that that plant needs out of the soil, which means you have to put that nutrient back into the soil. The easiest way to do that is with a synthetic fertilizer. So because we've been doing that for so many years now, when you get into the garden, there's a lot of companies that are willing to sell you synthetic fertilizers or organic fertilizers to make up for the lost nutrients in the soil. And if you do a search on fertilizers, you'll often find lots of recommendations for what you're supposed to do. It's not very often that you see a recommendation, even from some universities and extension offices, where they'll say, build the soil first. And if you build a healthy soil, you can throw away the fertilizers. Instead, we have it in our minds that we need fertilizers, and then we have all that confusion of when and where and how much. Focus on your soil. Soil is the key. Build your soil, and you can discard the need for fertilizers. Right about now, you might be saying, but Gardener Scott, that's too much work to bring in wheelbarrow loads of organic material and dig it into the soil. I don't want to work that hard, or I'm not capable of working that hard. I get it. I understand. And fertilizer is an easy way to feed your plants. If that's the approach you take, where you want to use fertilizer, again, focus on the soil. Enrich your soil with synthetic or organic, whichever way you want to go, but encourage that microbial growth within your soil. Don't spray your plants and feed your plants and expect that that's going to do anything, because your soil is not getting any better. Just by adding some fertilizer to your soil and then using organic mulches, over time your soil will get better. It may take longer than that 3 to 5 years, but it can get better to the point that you don't need to fertilize anymore. And then that's the least amount of labor you're going to have to deal with. I encourage you to know your soil, to really know it, to understand the nutrients that are present, so that if you add fertilizers, you know what fertilizers to add. The best way to do this is with a professional laboratory soil analysis, and that's what I did for my whole garden before I put my first bed in place. I know that my soil is deficient in nitrogen and phosphorus and potassium, the big three that all the plants need. Most of the other minerals are pretty good, though some are low. So as I built this bed with my native soil, I knew exactly what kind of fertilizer to put in place. So that Osmocote is high in nitrogen, it's got the phosphorus, it's got the potassium, a few other micronutrients, and was perfect for this bed. That's why I used it. When you get an analysis done, you'll know the deficiencies in your soil. So rather than just fertilizing, you know exactly what to target in your soil. If you garden in straw bales and containers, then you're probably going to need fertilizer just because the growing medium doesn't have a lot of nutrients. Even though this straw is decomposing, it's not adding enough nutrients to what these plants need, so I have to fertilize. And these containers have a soilless mix. It's peat and compost and vermiculite, also not a lot of nutrients. So adding the fertilizer can make a difference. realize how you're growing and again, what the soil needs. Because I know that peat has no nutrition. I know that I'm going to have to add some fertilizer to a soilless mix like this. And in perennial beds like this, you'll often hear it recommended that you need to add fertilizer because I can't move these plants. I can't move the asparagus. I can't move the rhubarb and the comfrey and the currants and everything else that's growing in this bed. So the idea that I can't get in here and amend with organic material implies that I have to use fertilizers. Well, I used a lot of organic material when I filled this area with soil, and then I put organic mulch on top of it. And a little later in this season, I'll top dress it with some compost or some aged manure, and I'll continue to add organic mulch. I'm going to let nature and the soil organisms take all of those organics on the top and continue to work them in the soil. So, even though I can't get in here and manually amend the soil with organics, do I need fertilizers? No, I don't think so. And after a year, these plants are doing fine with absolutely no additional fertilization. I don't like working in the garden any harder than I need to, but I don't think taking one day out of the year to amend the soil that needs amending is that much work, especially because I do that, and now I don't have to buy fertilizers and apply them on multiple days during the growing season. I think that's a pretty good trade-off. Amending your soil, building your soil, enriching your soil is something you really need to do to reach not only the balance of labor, but that equilibrium within the soil of all the nutrients you need. I have other videos that talk about soil, and there will be many more. And so to continue on your journey, not just about soil, but everything else, I encourage that you click on one of these videos to learn more about gardening and to become a better gardener. I'm Gardener Scott. Enjoy gardening.